examined. That's what really brought it. Thank you, Madam Chairman, and I'd appreciate the testimony from the witnesses and the future panel, too. My big concern is this is the day of the Exxon Valdez tragedy, not disaster, tragedy. And I want to stress that because in the aspect of oil in our waters, American waters, and I know I talked to a captain who's going to be on the next panel, I have figures that show that of petroleum transportation, 4% contribute to the pollution of our waters. Drilling, extraction, and delivery, other than by tanker, is 1% in our waters. Cars, fishing boats, pleasure boats, and others, 32%. And what I'm leading up to is we're talking about whether we do or whether we don't drill. The biggest polluter we have is Mother Nature itself. 63% of the oil that goes into our water comes from nature. Seeps that go into the water. And I haven't seen us, I hope we're not thinking about capping Mother Nature. I mean, it'd be a good stimulus package, by the way. We put a lot of people to work. And what I would urge that whatever comes out of these hearings, whatever we do, we understand the necessity of fossil fuel. The necessity of fossil fuel. That is something we have to understand. Mr. Brown mentioned it. We imported this year 13 million barrels of oil a day. We actually imported a total amount of 4 billion barrels, down near 5 billion barrels from overseas. That's $453 billion we sent overseas. We can't continue to do that. And unfortunately, those that oppose drilling or exploratory of offshore also oppose drilling and exploratory onshore in every area of the United States, even where the states want to do that. And we can't continue to put our heads in the sand when we are a nation of fossil fuels. You know, you think about it for a moment, the new 787, the reason it's going to be so efficient and will contribute to climate change is the fact that it uses 50% of that plane as composites made from fossil fuels. Fertilizers for our crops that feed the nations and the world are made from fossil fuels, natural gas and oil. Automobiles. You think about it, everything in that automobile now today is made from fossil fuels. The tires, the navigation instruments, most of the, other than the engine, is all made from fossil fuels. And so what I'm concerned about, Madam Chairman, we go through this series of hearings, we have to start thinking about this nation for the future of it, including fossil fuels and all those other components that will contribute power. Your windmills, I hear a lot about wind. Those propellers are being made from fossil fuels. And I can go on down and go on and on about the amount of products made from fossil fuels, and I won't do it as my time is running out. But keep in mind, the parts of the barrel, that's made, of 42 gallons of oil, there is actually, of that, 42 gallons of barrel, there's 19 gallons of gasoline. There's 8-9 gallons of diesel. There's 3 gallons of jet fuel. There's 1-2 gallons of heating oil. And then there's 24% of the barrel, 11 gallons, is the other things that you use every day. If I was to remove everything in this room that was made by fossil fuels, you'd all be in pretty sad shape. You think about it. I mean, it goes from your eyeglasses to medicines. One of the things that always tickles me, to Pampers, and I'd like to eliminate Pampers. And for these young ladies that may have a baby in the future, you think about it a moment. These glasses, get rid of them. I don't like them. Get rid of this too. But I can go on down the line. When we finally come together as a Congress and say, we want to address this power issue, this energy dependency, but you're not going to do it unless we consider the fact we must have a percentage of fossil fuels that are domestically produced. And then that day happens, with all the other added to it, we'll have a nation that's independent from foreign oil. And that's what I seek to do. But think about that when you have these hearings. Let's not get caught in this trap of Dr. No. Because I'll hear people, we don't want it in Anwar. We don't want any onshore drilling in Colorado. We don't want any onshore drilling any place in the United States. And yet you have to have fossil fuels or we cannot exist. And I thank you, gentlemen, for allowing me to go ahead. And thank you, Madam Chairman. I appreciate it.